You know, guys, most AI tools out there just scrape the web and hand you a pile of links. But what if one could actually think deeper? That's exactly what the new MGX update promises with its brand new deep research mode. And at the center of it all is an agent called Iris. I'm Daniel. Welcome to my channel, where I make smart tutorials. In this video, I'm going to put Iris to the test. We'll see how it takes raw research and transforms it into a 25-page report, and then watch as it builds a full AI-powered market research platform. Also, I've left all the useful links in the description down below, so don't forget to check them out. So let's dive in and find out if MGX really delivers on turning data into decisions. Okay, guys, so today I'm testing the new MGX update with the new deep research mode. The star here is an agent called Iris. Unlike a regular search tool, it doesn't just pull info from the web, it digs deep, cross-analyzes data from multiple sources, and turns it into practical insights. And here's something cool to know. MGX tested Iris against industry-leading AI tools on Deep Research Bench, and the results speak for themselves. Iris outperforms Gemini, OpenAI, Kimi, and Perplexity. To show this in action, I'll build an AI-powered market research platform that highlights everything this new MGX version can do with deep research enabled. The goal here, folks, is to run a full analysis of the best artificial intelligence tools and platforms for programming and software development in 2025. Iris will find the most effective and innovative coding assistants, while the dev team builds a site to compare them side by side. And here's the cool part. I can work directly with the agent. I turn on deep research mode and ask Iris a question, like, research the latest trends in AI-powered market analysis. I launch the generation, the agent gets to work, and in a moment the research is complete. What I get is a full 25-page report on the topic. It includes an introduction, a deep dive into core AI technologies with detailed tables, comparisons, and functions, plus key marketing trends and insights, current industry applications, and full market analysis. Basically, all the detailed information I'd need for this research. And it doesn't stop there. I can even take this report and instantly generate a website or a full PowerPoint presentation straight from the research. The most important part here is the practical insights, folks. Personalized recommendations for different types of users. Whether you're a solo developer, a small startup team, or a large enterprise, Iris doesn't just give you information. It delivers strategic analytics you can actually use to make decisions. Guys, let me take a little break to ask you to like this video and subscribe to my channel. It's absolutely free but helps me make even more fun tutorials for you. Thanks! Now, guys, let's see how it turns all that research into a live working web platform. I click Generate a website, and the dev team jumps in. Alex takes the report ID that Iris generated, transforms it into a structured dataset, and starts the build process. In just a moment, we've got a fully functional site. It's clean, interactive, and built for real-world use. Right away, I see a full comparison of future AI tools for developers, complete with analytics and conclusions for each platform. There are several tabs, folks. The market tab shows the overall trajectory of the industry. The tools tab gives detailed breakdowns of existing services and platforms with powerful filters by category and search options. This makes it easy to explore and even add new innovations later. The categories tab organizes everything by growth stage, high growth, emerging, or stable. You can also sort by use cases, case studies, best practices, strategies, and metrics. Inside each section, there are extra tabs like challenges and recommendations, giving not just the analysis, but also actionable steps and results. And guys, we also get a look into the future with sections like future outlook and emerging innovations. In the innovations tab, I can see the key breakthroughs driving artificial intelligence forward. There's also skills evolution, showing which skills are growing in demand, which ones are fading, and which new ones are emerging. Emerging trends covers things like multi-agent systems, AI development agents, and multimodal AI integration, basically all the hot directions the industry is moving in. There's even a societal impact section that looks at talent management, democratization, quality expectations, and how all of this might play out year by year. It doesn't stop there, folks. Ethical considerations and governance are also included, giving a clear picture of the challenges ahead. One of the strongest features here, a real must-have, is the recommendation tool. I can set parameters like team size, my main use case, the ecosystem I want to work in, and my priorities. Then it generates a personalized recommendation of which AI platform fits me best. That's incredibly useful, guys. Finally, I can publish the whole platform right away, either on an MGX dev domain or connected to my own. Once deployed, it's live online for clients, users, or an audience to explore. Honestly, this is a very powerful platform. Alright guys, so that's the new MGX update with Iris in action. Honestly, I'm impressed. It's not just pulling data, it's giving you deep research, real insights, and even a fully working platform you can share right away. That's next level stuff. If you want to create your own AI-powered market research platform, feel free to remix my use case. I'll share the link in the video description. Don't forget to share your MGX creation with me as well. And I'd love to hear from you. What do you think about this kind of AI-powered research? Do you see yourself using it for coding, business, or maybe something totally different? If you're excited to try it out, or if you've already used it and have some thoughts to share, drop a comment below. I'd love to hear your experiences. Don't forget to hit that like button if you found this video helpful, and subscribe for more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and till next time.